Well, where's the clicker? What I wanted to talk about, me and Sunny was kind of on the same page about the blood loss. So Sunny did the medical side, which was amazing, that I figured out that we look at this picture a million times and it did great, but when I read about that, his fingernails were blue and that his lips were blue and he was probably whiter than the walls, it's not here. So I looked into the blood loss, and Sunny did great with the explaining about the soda bottles and how much blood he lost. So I looked into what a victim, someone that's suffering from this kind of blood loss, what they go through. Like someone who's been shot or someone who's got shot in the war. The symptoms they go through when they suffer that kind of wound, that they're gonna die. If you understood what Sunny said, once you lose enough blood, it's over. So the biggest doctors in the world, if they wheel in somebody, a patient, that's definitely not gonna make it because they're suffering from too much blood loss, they're gonna tell them, hold on, don't worry, you're gonna make it. Or in the war, you see medics come to the guy that they shot, they say, don't worry, just hold on a little longer, we're gonna get you home, you're gonna get home to your family. They're never gonna tell them, you're not gonna make it, you're shot. They're not gonna say that. I always thought that was just to be nice. But medically speaking, when somebody's suffering that kind of trauma or that kind of wound, and they're definitely gonna die, somebody comforting them and telling them, hold on just a little longer, we're gonna get you home, son, in the war, you're gonna make it to your family. This releases a chemical in the brain that makes what's happening to them more bearable. So this is why the doctors do that. But here's the problem. Christ didn't have anybody to tell him, don't worry, you're gonna make, he knew he had to die. So every blow he took, everything he suffered, his disciples abandoned him. He said, my God, why have you forsaken me? There was nobody to make this bearable. After the first whip, there wasn't even a thought in his brain as, yo, I can't wait till this is over with so I can go home. He knew he has to die. So I looked up three major things, someone that's dying from blood loss, what they go through. And we'll go to the first one if this clicker works.
Hey, it worked, right?
Someone who's dying will ask or worry for their children. This is what they do. Someone who's suffering from enough blood loss that they're a lost cause. They're gonna die. So how could we relate this to Jesus? What did Jesus do? Jesus said, Father, forgive them for they know not what they are doing. And the soldier gambled for his clothes, and they were throwing dice. This is the first cry from the cross. Jesus was worried about his children. This is where his mind was while he was dying. He was worried about us. He said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. They ask or worry for their parents, their mother and father. A patient will say, where's my mother? Where's my father? They're worried about what's going on. So how could we relate this to Jesus while he was going through this? The third cry from the cross. Jesus told John, woman, this is your son. And he said, this is your mother to John. So he was worried about his mother while this was happening. What I'm trying to paint a picture of, this is not a fairy tale. This wasn't something we just read about. This was an actual death that's relatable to someone suffering a normal, actual death. This is where Jesus' mind was. He was worried about us, his children, and his mind even went to his mother. He was worried about his parents. And the third one I'm closing with, it was just a small one, but this is very interesting if you pay attention. This is D-Day on the beach of Normandy, June 6, 1944. This is World War II. Let me explain what this is. This is World War II, and what's happening is America is gonna storm the beach. They're coming on boats, and they're gonna win. It's gonna be the greatest day ever. It was the biggest disaster ever in American history. In the whole Afghanistan war, listen to this, Pastor. In the whole Afghanistan war, all those years it lasted, from September 11 till they got bin Laden, America lost 4,500 soldiers in all those years. On this day on the beach, one day, they lost 28,000 soldiers. How many of them died? And there's a guy, Joe, who made it out. Putovo made it. He was one of the first people to touch the sand, to go in. And he watched all of this disaster happening. And he's seen all the death around him. He made it. He made it home. But he watched 28,000 men die. They were ambushed. And they asked him, what was the worst thing about the day? And he didn't say it was the bombs or the landmines or watching all the Gajay die or all the blood. They said, what was the worst thing about it? He said, the thing that kept me up at night was the cries I could hear from the people that were dying and bleeding out. I'm so thirsty. Water, water. This is what happened. This is what happened. And we could relate that to Christ again. They thirst and they ask for water. Jesus knew that his mission was not finished and he fulfilled the scripture. He said, I'm thirsty. So the same thing that someone goes through, he felt every pain. He felt every emotion. These are the top three things that someone goes through. And the thing I'm trying to say tonight is, let's remember Christ in this way, that it wasn't just the suffering, it was the emotional part too, like Sonny said, knowing that there was no one there for him, him being really thirsty. This is a real symptom of blood loss, is dehydration and being thirsty. And I just want to thank Jesus for everything he did. Who's our next guy up? God bless you.